Hi everyone, welcome back to my fourth and final installment on my Garrard 401 rebuild. So two or three things just to show you an update. So here you see I've got a custom built dust cover. And there's a chap on Facebook, PR Displays, it makes these up and to any size you want. This cost £100. It took about 4.5 weeks to come. As I say, you'll do it any size you require. That's the size I wanted. So yeah, £100, 4.5 weeks, and yeah. Keeps the dust off. You don't need it, obviously. You're just going to have to do a bit more dusting. So the second thing I added was just a wee isolation plinth here, help a wee bit isolation. And this is done by TLW Audio. It's just a guy on eBay, it sells these. It would have been nice if it was in the matching, was it maple, I think my wood is. It's in oak he does. You probably can get any wood, but that's his standard wood. And it was like £95. And again, he'll do any size you want. So I think that was pretty good value, really, £95. They come with spikes, but I got these, ignore the dust, these wee isolating feet from, you get them from China, they're about £20 and they sit in three ball bearings. Sort of matched the feet of the turntable a wee bit better. So, and doesn't cause, with the spikes, obviously doesn't cause any damage to your unit, not this unit. Really matters. So there we go. Okay, so I'll take the lid off again and just show you a bit more. Yeah, so one major change I've done again, and I've mucked about a wee bit with this because I've had like 6-8 months, and I got the arm, there was two arms that originally, tone arms I was after for this my turntable project here, and one was SME 309, which was my preference arm, really, because Garrard and SME sort of go hand in hand, and in fact SME now own, as we all know, Garrard, and I've got a 309 12 inch tone arm on my 301, but they don't come up very often, as is this. This is I managed to finally pick up Riga RB3000. This is a tone arm. It's on Riga Planar 10 turntable. So at the moment, it's a top tone arm, and it was one I was after, and finally picked up one. These cost I think about £1,430 brand new. I managed to get a nearly new one for a great price, £800, so I couldn't give it up, really. I mean, all the Riga tone arms look exactly the same, more or less. They're built identical, almost, and you can pay between £200 and, obviously, £1,430 for whatever you're after. So, yeah, pleased to get the Riga RB3000. It's been a while now. Riga tone arms are built, they're non-adjustable, unlike most tone arms, so they're built for the Riga Planar turntables. So if you use them on any other turntable, you will need spacers. And even on a Riga Planar, if you use certain cartridges that are taller, you may need to use something. Riga do 2-inch. Two millimeter spacer. So I've had to build this quite up quite a bit. and I've got a dodgy looking 8mm spacer there. It's adjustable to 8, 6, I think, and 4. But I've also on above that, you can't see, I've got a 6 and a 2, so I've had to take up quite a bit. I'm going to do something with this. So I'm going to get another spacer built to size, I think. Get a proper arm board. I think I can maybe double up in the arm board from the company and use two, so that's one, it's inserted. I think if I get one the same size, it'll take it up and it'll just be like one solid thing. So anyway, finally here, finally got. If a 309 comes up, I may change it, but I'm not in a hurry, to tell you the truth. I'm really delighted with this. It's been a long haul. I'll just do a quick recap now. This whole project's cost me about £3,500. Now, it doesn't have to cost you that. Turntable, £900. This is a good quality. You can find these sometimes in charity shops and whatever for nothing. I mean, you can get them for nothing, but you can pay hundreds and thousands for them. So I paid a good price for that, a fair price and a good price for a well looked after one, which was £900. The Michelle clamp, obviously, I got second hand. The Vertery Sabre. It's not really coming into focus here. Vertery Sabre moving magnet cartridge, which is cost £900, which is a lot of money for a moving magnet, but moving magnet is what I wanted. And obviously I've got the Loricraft power supply, which I'm going to put my other turntable through that too at some point. I'll do a connection, as you don't have both on at the same time. So there you go, it's my moving magnets set up, and that's my high-end MC set up. Okay, thanks for your time, catch you later, bye then. I'll play a bit of music out, just have a bit of music in the video.